ஷெட்யூல்டு போயிடுமா? ஓகே. ஸ்ரீ குருப்யோ நமஹ. வார்ம் வெல்கம் டு யூ ஆல் இன் இண்டியா அண்ட் அப்ராட். வி வில் ஸ்டார்ட் அவர் ப்ரோக்ராம் வித் எ ப்ரேயர் பை ஸ்ரீமதி தனலக்ஷ்மி அண்ட் டீம் ஆஃப் ஸ்ரீ காமாட்சி ஸ்ரீ வித்யா சமிதி. ஓவர் டு ஸ்ரீ காமாட்சி ஸ்ரீ வித்யா சமிதி, ப்ளீஸ்.
ஸ்ரீ குருப்யோ நமஹ. भूषा भोगी फणा रत्न रोचिगी सिचय चारवे नमः प्रवीण मुक्ताय हर कल्प महीरुहे भालं வன்னிஷிகாங்கிதம் ஸ்ரோத்ரம் வஹன் சம்ருத க்ரீட குண்டலிஜ்ருங்கிதம் ஜலதிஜ சாயாஜ கண்டச்சவிஹி வக்ஷோபிப்ரதஹீனகஞ்சுகசிதம் பத்ராங்கநாதஸ்ய பாகபுங்கமலக்ஷ்மணோஸ்து யஶசி வாமோதவ தக்ஷிணஹ.
Thank you, Sri Kamakshi Sri Vidya Samiti. Just a few lines before we hand over to Sri Kannan. Founded in 2014 with His Holiness blessings, Sri Kamakshi Sri Vidya Samiti imparts training in traditional practices, home and puja related, and conducts loka and sampradaya classes for children. Thank them for their participation today and during our next session, that is next Saturday also. With our namaskarans to His Holiness Shankara Vijayendra Saraswati Swamikal, and with His blessings, we continue with our Kashmir Cultural Heritage Lectures, fourth in our series by Sri P.R. Kannan. Sri Kannan needs no introduction, as this is the second of six lectures in total. Sri Kanchi Math has been in the forefront, modestly working with the sole aim of national integration, spiritual enlightenment, and spreading the uniqueness, as Kashmir is our cultural heritage. We thank Sri Kanchi Math for giving us this opportunity to organize, and also thank all our speakers participating in this ongoing series. We thank our viewers, as we see our viewership steadily increasing. We also thank Kanchi Math staff team for introducing us in Kamakodi TV, YouTube, and Facebook channels of Kanchi Math from today. Thank you very much. Now, we request Sri Kannan to take over. His two sessions are going to be on Raja Tarangini. Sri Kannan.
Shruti Smriti Purana Naam Alayam Karunalayam Namami Bhagavat Pada சங்கரம் லோகசங்கரம் சதாசிவசமாரம்பாம் சங்கராச்சாரிய மத்யமாம் அஸ்மதாச்சாரிய பர்யந்தாம் வந்தே குரு பரம்பராம். மோகம் கரோதி வாசாலம் பங்கும் லங்கயதே கிரிம் யத் கிருபா தமஹம் வந்தே பரமானந்த சத்குரும். அகஜானன பத்மார்க்கம் கஜானன மஹர்நிஷம் அநேக தந்தம் பக்தானாம் ஏகதந்தமுபாஸ்மஹே. ஸ்ரீராம சௌமித்ரி ஜடாயுவேத ஷடானநாதித்ய குஜார்ச்சிதாய ஸ்ரீநீலகண்டாய தயாமயாய ஸ்ரீ வைத்யநாதாய நம சிவாய. நம பார்வதீபதயே ஹர ஹர மகாதேவா. சர்வத்ர கோவிந்த நாம சங்கீர்த்தனம். கோவிந்தா கோவிந்தா ஸ்ரீ ஜெகதம்பிகாயை ஜய ஜயா. Today's subject is Raja Tarangini, our Acharya Swamiji has been very keen on spreading the awareness of the rich Kashmiri culture. And in that context, he has been mentioning Raja Tarangini quite a few times. Because Raja Tarangini, Tarangini means river. It is the river of kings. That means, like a river, the story of the kings of Kashmir is flowing from one Raja to the other Raja. And Kalhana, a Brahmana poet of the 12th century, has authored this epic, this Kavya, in Sanskrit poetry. Now, he has covered the history of Kashmir up to 1148 AD, 12th century, 1148 AD. He is in fact celebrated as the first author of recognized Indian history. His father, Champaka, was a minister in the court of King Harsha of Kashmir. Now, Raja Tarangini goes into 8 Tarangas. Taranga means chapter, 8 chapters, 8 Tarangas. Total of 7,826 shlokas. Every chapter, every Taranga starts with a stotra of Shiva, generally Ardhanarishwara. The two shlokas which are chanted as prayers at the beginning of this session are from the first Taranga, the Dhyana shlokas in the first Taranga. Now, Kalhana gives an eye-catching picture of the kings who ruled Kashmir, their vices and virtues, their history, their politics, their political plots, their religious inclinations, their attempts to serve the people of Kashmir in various ways. Everything. He goes into great detail. He describes the temples built by them, not only built by the king, built by the queens, built by the ministers, built by the officers, the rivers, the springs, the mathas, the agraharas, so many things. He also refers to the influence of Buddhism, the invasion of hostile forces like Yavanas, as he calls them, the Greeks, the Mlechas, as he calls them, the Muslims who came later. Kalhana describes the qualities of the kings, the various political developments, the religious developments, etc., in terms which are embedded in our Sanatana Dharma. His descriptions of nature and all the king's characteristics, king's actions, etc. He quotes stories from Puranas, local legends, Shastras, etc., whenever he goes into such descriptions. And he breaks into expressions of morals, ethics, unseen causes, consequences, real Kavya in the full sense of the term. He gives the glimpses of the various temples, mathas, agraharas, etc., irrigation works, roads, canals, armies, etc., which he comes across continuously throughout the history. Now, this Raja Tarangini covers up to 1148 AD, starting from Mahabharata times. And this is followed by another Raja Tarangini by Jona Raja, another poet. He covers from 1148 to 1412, another 300 years. There is a lesser known Raja Tarangini, Jona Raja Tarangini. Then another Jaina Raja Tarangini, on Srivara. He covers another 60 years, short time. Then a fourth Raja Tarangini, he is by Prajyabhatta and Shuka. They cover another 300 years, mainly Muslim rule. Even Muslim rule is covered in beautiful Sanskrit poetry by those two poets. Now, let me start with Taranga 1 of Kalhana's Raja Tarangini. The first shloka which our Sri Vidya Kamakshi Samiti chanted, Bhusha Bhogi Phanaratna Rochisthitaya Charave Nama Pralina Muktaya Harakalpa Mahiruhe. This describes Shiva as shining brilliantly with the gems in the serpent's hooves and in whom liberated people merge, Pralina Muktaya. And he is like a Kalpataru, Hara Kalpa Mahiruhe. Mahiruhe means Vriksha, Kalpa Vriksha. He is like a Kalpa Vriksha and he is like a tree, means he is like a Sthanu. Sthanu is one of the names of Shiva. Unchanging, and he gives refuge to devotees. In fact, Kashmir religious history has got something to do with Shiva as a tree. We will come to that a little later. The second shloka, Bhalam Vanni Shikankitam, etc., which they sang, describes the Ardhanarishwara form of Shiva. First, the common features of both Shiva and Parvati, like the third eye, Agni Netra, then the two ears, one, both he is describing as Kundalas. Actually, Kundala is the term meaning two things. One is snakes as well as Tatankas. Then he talks about the Halahala mark on his throat. Halahala poison born of milk ocean, he says. Jaladeja Chaya Chakanta Chavihi. Then he says his chest is adorned with a snake on one side and excellent brows of Parvati on the left. Now he concludes saying, your fame is spread by Vamothaba Dakshinaha. We don't know whether it is Vama part or Dakshina part, the right part or the left part. We don't know. Both parts are equally responsible for your great fame. Like that he concludes. Now he says, the fame of a good poet is immortal. I shall, with the blessings of Saraswati, narrate this history without any attachment or hate. Shlaghyastaya eva gunavan raga dvesha bahishkrita bhutartha katane yasya. Bhutartha katane, what is past? Sthayasya eva Saraswati. Saraswati is sthaya. Saraswati is the judge who is going to help me, guide me. Tadamandarasasyanda sundareyam nipiyatam shrotra shukti putai spashtam angaraja taranginim. Like in Srimad Bhagavatam, Pibhata Bhagavata Rasam. Like that he says here also, Rasasyanda Sundareyam Nipiyatam. Please come and partake of this Sundara Rasa. Shrotra Shukti Putehi, with your ears. Now he refers to the past history of Kashmir, which were available in his time. Mainly he refers to two histories, Suvrata and Kshemendra, and he criticizes both of them. He says both of them are marked by error as well as incompleteness. So he is not saying they are good histories, and he has consulted 11 such past histories. One is called Parthivavali by a Brahmana called Hela Raja, 12,000 verses. Then he has consulted royal inscriptions, ordinances of past kings, written palace records, judicial records. Then most important, he has consulted Neelamata Puranam. We have a separate lecture on that, which is a Purana referring to Kashmir's religious history. And he has also visited personally several temples, monuments, ruins, etc. Now, he claims that in his Raja Tarangini, the main rasa is Shanti Rasa. Chanabhangini Jantu Naam Spurite Parichintite Murdha Abhisheka Shantasya Rasasyatra Vicharyatam. My rasa is Shanti Rasa. Now, let us look at the various histories of kings which he is trying to describe. Now, he starts with Kashyapa. All of us know that Kashmir means, it starts with Kashyapa. He also starts with Kashyapa. Kashyapa is the grandson of Brahma, son of Marichi, as all of us know. Now, Kalhana says, for 6 Manvantaras, now we are in the 7th Vaivasvata Manvantara now, for 6 Manvantaras, Kashmir was a complete sheet of water. It was known as Sati Sara. Sati Parvati, Sati Sara. Sara means sheet of water, lake. So it's a lake in the name of Sati. Sati Sara it was known as. Then when Vaivasvata Manvantara started, what happened? He says, Kashyapa got Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva to come and break the mountains, drain the waters. Then there was an asura called Jalodbhava. He made Vishnu kill Jalodbhava, the asura, and then he founded the territory of Kashmir. Kashyapa founded the territory of Kashmir. He's telling it in beautiful shlokas.
Jalodbhava.
Established Kashmira Mandala. Now, how is Kashmira Mandala? He goes into top-notch praise of Kashmir in so many shlokas. He says, let me talk about river Vitastha, because Raja Tarangani, you will find mention of Vitastha river very frequently. Vitastha is nowadays known as Jhelum. The ancient Vedic name is Vitastha. Even Rigveda refers to Yamame Gange Yamane. There, Vitastha name is mentioned. Now, he says, it is Uma, Parvati herself, who has taken the form of Vitastha. Gauri yatra Vitastha tum yata pyujhati nochitam yat sarvanaga dhishena nilena paripalyate. The first inhabitants of Kashmir were Nagas. Then humans came after a few years. There is a story behind it, which we will go into when we go to Nilamata Purana. Now, the initial kingdom was Naga kingdom. Nagas are not humans. They are semi-divine beings. Nila was their head. Sarva Nagadhishena Nilena Paripalyate. The Nilamata Puranam is actually a Puranam told by that Nila, that Naga head, to a Brahmana. Now, he says, Bhukti Mukti Phala Praptihi Kashtarupam Umapatim Papa Sudana Tirthantaha Yatra Samsprishatam Bhavet. There is a Tirtha called Papa Sudana Tirtha, one which destroys your sins. And there, Kashtarupam Umapatim, Shiva is in the form of wood, wooden image. There is a tradition in Kashmir, even in those days, Kashyapa's days, to have wooden images of Umapati. Bhukti Mukti Phala Praptihi. You get bhukti as well as mukti. Pleasure in this world as well as liberation for the next world. And on the top of the hill, Sandhya Devi appears in the form of water, he says. That means wherever there is water, that is Sandhya Devi, which is available for Punyatmas. For Papatmas, there is no water. Sandhya Devi Jalam Yasmin Datte Nissalile Girav Darshanam Punya Papanam Anvaya Vyatirekayoho. Then, on hills, you find Jwalamukhi fire, volcano fire, and he picturizes that volcano as Brahma. Svayambhur yatra huta bhuvo garbhat samunmishan. Brahma accepts the Havya offering, whatever we offer in Homa, that he accepts. Brahma himself comes and accepts in the form of Jwalamukhi. Juhpatam pratigrinnati Jwala bhujabanair havihi. Then on the top of the hill, Bhedagire, Devi herself is giving darshan. Devi Bhedagire Shringe Gangodbhejasutau Swayam. Then there is Ganga on the top of the hill. In that there is a lake. In that lake, Saraswati is appearing as a Hamsa. Look at all the descriptions. How deeply religious he is starting the story of Kashmir. Sarvantara drishyate yatra Hamsa rupa Saraswati. Saraswati is in the form of Hamsa. In that lake on the top of the hill, where Ganga is rising. Nandikshetre hara vasa prasade dyucharapitaha Adhyapi yatra vejyante puja chandana bindavaha. Nandikshetra is another famous Shiva shrine which comes for frequent mention throughout Rajatarangini. All kings have bowed at the feet of Shiva in Nandi Kshetra, very famous Shiva Kshetra. There he says, Devas used to come and worship Shiva, and the remnants of the puja materials left by Devas, puja chandana bindavaha, they are still appearing. Still means in Kalhana's time, I can see them, he says. Adhyapi yatra vijyante, puja chandana bindavaha. Alokya saradam devim yatra samprapyate kshanat. Tarangini madhumati vani cha kavisevita. Now he is talking about Sharada. Sharada Peetham, which we all know, is in POK, 10 kilometers away from our present LOC. Now that Sharada is on the top of a hill where Madhumati is the river on the banks of Madhumati. Madhumati is nowadays known as Kishan Ganga. Now, ancient name was Madhumati. Why it is called Madhumati? There is a story which he is telling us in Nelamatha Purana. Now, there is another river called Shandili or Saraswati. Here he is calling it as Vani, Saraswati. The junction of these two rivers marks the location of Sharada Peetha. Now, he is constructing the shloka in such a way, it gives two meanings, very beautiful. Alokya Sharadam Devi Yatra Samprapyate Kshanati. When you have darshan of Sharada Devi there, Tarangini, Madhumati, Vani, Chakabhisevita. There are two rivers, Madhumati and Saraswati, Vani. That is one meaning. Second meaning is, you will get Vani, Kabhisevita. Even Kabis will praise your poetry. You will get that kind of gift when you go and worship Sharada. Tarangini, Madhumati. Your poetry will be so sweet and full of beautiful waves. Chakrabhrit Vijayeshadi Keshave Shanabhushite. तिलांशोपिनयत्रास्थे पृथिव्यास्तीर्थैहि बहिष्कृतः तिलांशोपि न यत्र अस्ति. देयर इज नॉट ए प्लेस ऑफ इवन अ ससाम सीड, इवन अ तिला विच इज नॉट हैविंग ए क्षेत्र आइदर चक्रभृत विजयेशादि केशव ईशान भूषिते विष्णु क्षेत्र और शिव क्षेत्र डिवॉइड ऑफ दीज क्षेत्र देयर इज नॉट ए स्पेस ऑफ इवन अ तिला. Kashmir is full of temples. That's what he himself says. We also know from the history. He is himself telling us so many temples he is describing. Every king has constructed a temple of Shiva. Every king. And every king has constructed a town in his name, an Agrahara in his name, which he has given to Brahmana, and a Matha. These are all, every king has done this. Then you can imagine. विजीयते पुण्यबलैहि बलैर्यत्तु न शस्त्रिणां परलोकात् ततो भीतिः यस्मिन् निवसतां परम्. यू कैनॉट विन कश्मीर बाय शस्त्र बल, यू कैन विन ओनली बाय पुण्य बल. ही सेज दैट ऑल किंग्स हैव कॉन्क्वर्ड कश्मीर बाय पुण्य बल, बाय द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ देयर पुण्य. एंड ऑल द प्रजा, ऑल द सिटीजन हैव बीन फॉलोइंग द पाथ ऑफ धर्म. परलोकात् भीतिः, दे आर अफ्रेड ऑफ what they will experience in the next loka, so they will never deviate from dharma. Yes, when nibhasatam param, then he goes into mundane descriptions of Kashmir. He says how beautiful Kashmir is. So shmasnana griha shite susthati raspadaraye yado virahita yatra nimnaga nirupadravaha. In severe winter there are hot springs, hot baths, and in summer you have the rivers which have ice water. Santapahatam janan yatra pitra vinirmite gaurava divatigmam shuhu dhatte grishmes yatibratam. Then will the sun be very harsh in summer? No, in summer sun is very cool. Even in summer, surya is not harsh. Dhatte grishme pi atibratam, not tibra. Then Vidya Veshma Nitungani Kunkumam Sahimam Payaha. It is known for Vidya, great scholarship. Sharada Peetha was a great university like Nalanda, like Takshashila. Very recognized, well recognized, very well respected. Great scholars used to be there. So he says, Vidya Veshma Nitungani, tall buildings, tall palaces, Kunkumam, saffron, Sahimam Payaha, ice water, naturally, it's coming from the hill. द्राक्षेति यत्र सामान्यम अस्ति त्रिदिव दुर्लभम द्राक्ष ग्रेप्स नाउ दिस आर ऑल स्पेशल फॉर कश्मीर त्रिदिव दुर्लभम इवन इन स्वर्गलोक यू विल नॉट गेट सच गुड क्वालिटी थिंग्स त्रिलोक्याम रत्नसु श्राद्ध्या तस्याम धनपते हरिते इन ऑल द थ्री वर्ल्ड्स रत्नसु दैट इज अर्थ विच प्रोड्यूसेस रत्नास श्राद्ध्या दैट इज द बेस्ट ऑफ ऑल द थ्री वर्ल्ड्स अर्थ इज द बेस्ट Tasyam Dhanapate Harite and on this earth, the northern direction, Dhanapati's direction, Kubera direction, the northern direction is the best. Tatra Gauri Guru Shailo, in the northern direction, Gauri Guru Shailaha, that is Himavan, Gauri Guru is Himavan, father of Gauri. Himavan, Shaila, the Himalayas, that is best. Yet Tasmin Napi Mandalam, there Kashmir is the best. That is how he concludes. Now he says, from the contemporaries of Kauravas and Pandavas up to Gonanda, 52 kings have passed into oblivion. Unfortunately, there was no good poet. He records that. There was no good poet to record the activities, the history of those kings. But he has tried to catch a few kings, which he is now talking about. He is talking about Gonanda the One. The first king he is talking about is Gonanda the One. Gonanda is a dynasty. Gonanda dynasty. This is in Krishna's time. So, this Gonanda supported Jarasandha. So, he died at the hands of Krishna during the war with Krishna. Then his son, Gonanda I's son, Damodara I, he also perished at the hands of Krishna in a different battle in Gandhara, where he had gone for a Swayamvara. There he died at the hands of Krishna. Now, what Krishna did was, this Damodara I's queen, his wife, she was pregnant at that time. Krishna installed her as the queen of Kashmir. Now, will you install a widow and that too a pregnant widow? This is the question will anybody would raise. People must have raised at that time. And Krishna silenced all those critics. What did he say? This is an exception, he said. Kashmira Parvati, this is Krishna's statement. Kashmira Parvati Tatra. Rajagnyaha Shivam Shagaha. Entire Kashmir is Parvati. And the king of Kashmir is Amsha of Shiva, Shivam Shagaha. Navajnyayasya Dushtopi Vidusha Bhuti Vichata. Dushtopi, even if that king is not virtuous, you should respect him. Vidusha Bhuti Vichata. He installed her. And then she was there after her son was born, Gonanda the Second. Then how religious people were there at that time. Tasya Rajya Abhishekadi Vidibhistha Sambhrataha Vijayendraihi Niravartyante Jata Karmadika Kriyaha. They did all religious rituals like Jata Karma, etc. They installed him as a king when he was even a child. And at that time, the Mahabharata war came up. Because he was a child, he was not invited to participate. This is recorded by Kalhana. It is also recorded in Nilamata Purana. Then there are some more kings about whom, some 35 kings about whom nothing much is known. He is leaving them. He goes to King Lava, who founded a city of, as I said, every king founded his own town, his own Agrahara, etc. This Lava founded a city of Lolor and 84 lakhs of stone houses he built in that town for people to live. And in Ledari town, he gave Agrahara to Brahmanas. Similarly, his son Kusha did. Then his son Khagendra became king. Then he was so virtuous. He says, Haraha sasitai krityaihi kritan lokan kramadyayau. When he left this world, Haraha sasitai krityaihi. What was his action? His actions were so virtuous that he brought smile on the face, those actions brought smile on the face of Shiva. Harahasa sitai krityaihi. Kritan lokan, he purchased superior worlds like Shivaloka, etc. by his punya krityas. Kramat yayau, he went to those lokas one by one. Then his son Surendra became king, and Surendra was such a great king that Devendra was no match to him, he says. Lebhe yasya surendrasya surendro no apamanatam. He also built a city called Sauraka, and he built a Vihara called Narendra Bhavan. First time we come across the word Vihara, which is a Buddhist temple. So Buddhism had already come in. So he says he built a Vihara called Narendra Bhavan. Then he talks about Godhara from another dynasty who took over. Then another king, Suvarna. Now the Suvarna, he talks about a canal called Suvarna Mani, which he constructed, and he gave gold to beggars, etc. He was so virtuous. Then comes Ashoka, our famous king, Ashoka, who took to Buddhism, as we all know. Now he also talks about his Buddhist inclinations. He built a tall Buddhist Vihara, as if touching the sky, he says. Then he created the town of Srinagar. Of course, there is the opinion that the present-day Srinagar is different from the Srinagar which was built by Ashoka. That is for archaeologists to say. Sashannavatyagehanam lakshair lakshmi samujvalaihi gariyasim purim shriman chakre Srinagarim nripaha shannavatya lakshaihi. 96 lakhs of houses he built there, resplendent with prosperity, lakshmi samujvalaihi gariyasim purim. Beautiful city he built. Then he built, rebuilt the compound wall of Vijayeshwara temple. He built a temple called Ashokeshwara. Every king built a Shiva temple in his own name. Ashoka, so Ashokeshwara, like that. If somebody is Vijaya, he will build Vijayeshwara, and so on. Then there was an attack on the kingdom from Naikshas, he says. Naikshas must be Greeks. Now, what did he do? He went to Bhuteshwara. Bhuteshwara is in that Nandikshetra, Shiva. He went and prayed to him for a son who will be able to fight the Mlechas. Mlechas sanchadite deshe sadadachutteye nrupaha tapas santoshital lebhe bhuteshate sukriti sutam sutam lebhe. He got a son, Sukriti, a virtuous son he got. From whom he got? Bhuteshate kripaya. Now that son is known as Jaloka. On Jaloka, he has got a very long story, and he says his kirti, his yashas, hit the entire Brahmanda Mandalam. Yasya divya prabhavasya katha shruti patham gataha ascharya charyatam yanti niyatam dyusadamapi. Even Devaloka, Devas, were talking about his exploits, his virtues. He expelled Mlechas, he conquered vast regions. Kashmir became a great kingdom, not just Kashmir, a vast kingdom in his time. And the place of victory where he eliminated these Mlechas was known as Ujjatadimba. That means where he exterminated these Mlechas. Jitvorvim kanyakubjado tatratyam sanyabeshayat chaturvarnyam nijedeshe dharmyanscha vavaharinaha. Very clearly he is talking about chaturvarnya and dharma. He says, he conquered Kanyakubja. Kanyakubja is in UP, present-day Uttar Pradesh. And from there, he brought good people and established Chaturvarnya and good dharma in his own kingdom by bringing good people from Kanyakubja. And he poetically, he says, he gained elixir of prosperity by dedicating gold to devatas in various temples. He had extraordinary siddhis. He could be under water for a long time. He had a jnani guru who defeated the Buddhists in debate. This kind of debating with Buddhists, or Buddhists having an upper hand, sometimes our Sanatanis having an upper hand, this comes repeatedly in Rajatarangini. He worshipped Vijayeshwara and Jaisteshwara in Nandikshetra. Now, about his ability to rule, about his governance. Beautifully he says, he established 7 officers of the state. 1 chief justice, Dharmadhyaksho Dhanadhyakshaha, Dhanadhyaksha, superintendent of revenue, Koshadhyakshaha Tamupatihi, treasurer, army chief, Dhuta Purodha Daivajnaha, emissary, Purohita, astrologer, Daivajna, astrologer, सप्त प्रकृतयो भवन सेवन ऑफिसर्स सेवन फंक्शनरीज एंड ही एस्टैब्लिश्ड द गवर्नमेंट सिस्टम ऑफ युधिष्ठिरा ही सेज ऑफ महाभारत फेम युधिष्ठिरीम स्थिति ही लाइक अदर किंग्स ही आल्सो एस्टैब्लिश्ड अग्रहारा हिज क्वीन ईशान देवी founded what is known as Matri Chakra. First time this term Matri Chakra comes, it comes frequently in Rajatarangini. Matri Chakra has been interpreted as Shri Chakra, we all know Shri Chakra, and also has been interpreted as Sapta Matrikas, a temple for Sapta Matrikas. Now, she founded Matri Chakra with great spiritual power, and this Jaloka had Vyasa's Shishya in his kingdom, and he heard Nandi Purana from him. Shruta Nandi Purana se Vyasa Antevasino Nripaha Pratishtham Jeshtarudrasya Srinagar Yam Vitanvata. Jeshteshwara, who was in Nandikshetra, he wanted another Jeshteshwara in Srinagar, so he established Srinagar. Of course, there is a view that this present Shankaracharya Hill, Jeshteshwara, is the one which is founded by Jaloka, this king. But there is a contrary view which will come to you later. That contrary view is likely to be correct. This may be another Jeshtarudra and another part of Srinagar. Now, he wanted that his Kshetra in Srinagar should vie with Nandikshetra. Nandikshetra is obviously a little far away. And Nandi Kshetra is marked by not only Shiva Kshetra, also by a river called, a spring called Sodara. Now, Kashmir is full of springs. Every Naga Devata is associated with a spring. So, there was a spring called Sodara in Nandi Kshetra, and he wanted a similar sacred spring in his own Srinagar Kshetra. I want to have something same as Nandikshetra. This was his sankalpa. So one day, because of his prayers to Shiva, he found a spring in Srinagar, and he found that water was very similar to Sodara water. Sodara, the spring in Nandikshetra. He was convinced, but how to convince others that this is same as Sodara, same sacredness, same sanctity as Sodara? Then what he did something extraordinary. He went to Sodara in Nandikshetra. He dropped there a pitcher, a golden pitcher, a closed golden pitcher in the waters of Sodara. And he picked up the same pitcher in the spring here in Srinagar after 2.5 days. So he proved that same water is coming here. That was the level of the sincerity of his devotion. Look at that. He wanted to establish Nandikshetra in Srinagar. He went all out for this purpose. Now, he succeeded in that. Then another story connected with him, very interesting. He was once proceeding to have darshan of Vijayeshwara in another town. Then on the way, he found a woman was begging for food. So she met him. She was begging for food. Then he said, okay, I'll give you food. Then as he was talking, she changed her form. Now, this kind of story, a lot of divine stories, you will find in Rajatarangini. Semi-divine, divine. Not credible in our present-day world, but they were obviously credible in those days. So, she assumed a different form, a hideous, terrible form, and asked for human flesh. I want human flesh as food. Now, this king was so virtuous, he said, okay, take my flesh. Take flesh from my own body. Then suddenly, that girl, that woman, she changed her form again. She said, no, I wanted to test you. Now you are Bodhisattva, Buddha. Then he didn't know anything about Bodhisattva. He was a Shiva worshipper, this king, Jaloka. So he said, what is this Bodhisattva? Who is Bodhisattva? Then she explained that all about Buddha, and your people have destroyed a Buddha Vihara on the other side of this hill. I am from that tribe, Kritika tribe. So if you please help us to re-establish that Buddha Vihara, I'll be grateful. Then he promised, then she left, and he built that Buddha Vihara and a Kritya Ashrama in the name of the Kritika woman. Now, at Nandikshetra, he built a grand temple for Bhuteshwara. There must have been a temple, he must have made it a grand temple. And finally, he spent his last days at the Shiva Kshetra called Kira Mochana. You find a lot of names for Shiva. All the kings were Shiva worshippers. You find several names of Shiva here. Even the two shlokas which we chanted at the beginning, you must have found very unusual names of Shiva there. Shiva Kshetra, Kira Mochana. And there he sat in Brahmasana and passed away in meditation. And what does Kalhana say about his passing away? Bhukte Ishwaryam Saparyante Pravishta Kira Mochanam. Patnyasamam Yayav Raja Sahayujyam Girijapatehe. Patnyasamam, along with his wife, he got Shiva Sahayujyam Girijapatehe. Then, next king was Damodara II. Very prosperous kingdom. He was a very great Shiva Bhakta. Hara Prasada Patrena Satcharitra Anuragina. Satcharitra Hara Prasada, Shiva Prasada. Bhavanda Sukhina Sakhyam. Yena Vaishravana Swayam. Vaishravana is Kubera. Kubera came and sought his friendship. Now, Kubera is known in our religious literature as the friend of Shiva. All of us know Kubera as the friend of Shiva. In fact, Shiva has given a corner to Kubera in his Kailasa mountain. So that Kubera comes down and seeks the friendship of this king. And Kubera, as all of us know, is head of Yakshas. So he brought Yakshas and he built a lot of dikes, like dikes and bridges across swamps, etc. in Kashmir. Then this king built Damodara Puram in the name of Damodara, his own name. He built a bridge called Gudda Setu. And now first time Kalhana breaks into a lot of moral statement, lot of statements of life's truths. He makes beautiful slokas he constructs to express. Sometimes his surprise, sometimes his resentment, etc. Here he says, such a great king, look at how the tide turns very badly in our human life. Hitam lokottaram kinchit kikirshoho unnatatmanaha rohantiha dhikpratyoha mitapunyatayandranam. Though the king was so virtuous, the praja, the citizens, did not have luck, good luck. So they lost him. Rohandhiha dhik pratyuha. Dhik, this is really detestable. The way the bad luck of the citizen worked against the king. So what happened? On the day he was performing Shraddha. Shraddha is also mentioned. On the day he was performing Shraddha, he was going for a bath in Vitastha river. We saw Vitastha, the very body of Parvati, present-day Jhelum. The most sacred river in Kashmir after Sindhu is Vitastha. Now, when he was about to go for a bath, a group of Brahmanas came. They said, we are very hungry. We want food. This king said, just wait for a while. Let me take bath. After I take bath, I will arrange for your food. They were so impatient, these Brahmanas. They said, no, we can't wait. You are walking towards the river, we will bring the river to you. They had so much of siddhis, powers. They turned the direction of Vitastha towards where the king was standing. He said, okay, here is the river. Now you can take your bath leisurely after. First you feed us, we are so hungry. King did not understand. Why there is so much of hurry? He said, now you have brought the river here, let me take bath and then I will give you. The Brahmanas became so angry, they cursed him to become a serpent. There he says, Dayadadi Balayarnashta Drishta Bhuja Samuthita Shri Vipra Vajnayara Ajnam Apunasambhava Punaha. We find a lot of palace intrigues. We are going to see a lot of them in other king stories also. So far also, a lot of such stories have happened. He says, your own relatives, your own dayadi, dayadadi balaihi. Your kingdom will go. That is not unusual. But when you disrespect, dishonor Lakshmi and Brahmana, Shri Vipra Avajnaya, then apunasambhava apunaha, then you cannot get up at all. That is the power of Brahmana. Bhojyam dadaminasnato vipras tarpata sampratam. He said, I will not give you food without my taking bath. I will take bath and then vipraha sarpata sampratam. You please give me way for taking bath. The vipraha sarpata, sarpa means move. The same sarpa, they word like in Agastya's story, Nahusha was cursed to become sarpa because of the same reason. There also, he said, Nahusha was sitting and Agastya was carrying the chariot, no? So he said, sarpa sarpa, move fast. Now here also, vipra sarpata sampratam. Then what did they say? Tene chuktaha tamashap. Tam ashapan tata sarpo bhavetite sarpo bhavadesi. Now, in fact, Kalkana records, even today I can see that sarpa. Now, next kings were Hushka, Jushka, and Kanishka. They were kings of Turushka origin, Turkish origin. They embraced, they encouraged Buddhism. They built a lot of viharas. Of course, they did not act very much against Sanatana Dharma. They also founded Jayaswamipura. They founded some mathas. The great Buddhist philosopher Nagarjuna was there in their kingdom and he spent a few days during their time. Then this was quickly followed by Abhimanyu, another great Hindu king. He was like another Indra, he says. And he built a Shiva temple with Shiva's image where his name was inscribed. Abhimanyu's name was inscribed. Then there were teachers like Chandracharya in his kingdom who taught Mahabhashyam and wrote Vyakarana books. This kind of mention happened frequently in at least a few times in Raja Tarangini. Great kings encouraging great poets, great scholars who write grammar books in Sanskrit based on Mahabhashya, Patanjali's Mahabhashya. Now, Mahabhashya itself was gone from Kashmir. So, this Chandracharya brought Mahabhashya. He taught to various disciples and he wrote Vyakarana books. Then, the fight between Buddhists and Sanatanis gained ground and there was a big battle between Nagas and Buddhists. Then there was great destruction during that battle. Then Chandradeva, one Brahmana of Kashyapa lineage, he performed a penance. He had darshan of Nila, the first Naga chief whom we saw earlier. He had darshan of Nila. Then that Nila intervened. He stopped the killing of Buddhists and he restored the primacy of Nila Purana rules. That means he established Sanatana Dharma once again. Now, the next king, Gonanda the third. Now, the time of this Gonanda, the period is 1184 BC. Now, of course, for most kings, Kalkana gives some kind of Kashmiri time, Kashmiri calendar time, which has been converted into this kind of our understandable time by historians. Now, Gonanda III, the period is 1184 BC. He restored Nila Purana rituals, yagas, pujas, yatras, etc. And he says, beautifully, he says, Kale Kale Praja Punyaihi Sambhavanti Mahibhujaha Yair Mandalasya Kriyate Durotsannasya Yojanam. Because the previous king, there was a lot of destruction because of the Buddhists. Now he says, frequently this happens and good kings also come and then restore virtue, dharma. Ye praja pidana paraha te vinashyanti dhanvayaha. Those kings who destroy the well-being of praja, they themselves die. That is the nature of dharma. Nashtamtiye yojaye yuhu te sham vamsa anugasyaha. Nashtamtiye yojaye yuhu. Those kings who come later and then restore order, their vamsha, tesham vamsha anugaha shriyaha, they prosper. And he gives a beautiful example here. Gonanda Anvayanam Adhyaha Saraghunam Raghuryatha. This king, Gonanda the third, he was for the Gonanda Vamsha, Gonanda dynasty, he was like Raghu in Raghu Vamsha. Raghunam Raghuryatha. He was the greatest in that lineage. Then there was a king called Vibhishana the first. Then there was a king called Indrajit. Then there was a king called Ravana. You find all these Ramayana names here. This Ravana king, he worshipped a Shiva limb image called Vateshwara Linga. And what is speciality about this Vateshwara Linga? It had luminous dots and lines. Luminous dots and lines, Rekha. Bindu Rekha Shavirgyasya Drishta Bhavyartha Shamthini. Drishta Bhavi Artha Shamthini. That those Rekhas and those Bindus would foretell the future. That was the speciality. Saravanasya Pujartham Lingam Bhati Vateshwaraha. Then there was a king called Nara. And what happened was, a Buddhist in a monastery, he kidnapped one of his queens. So this Nara, he was also known as Kinnara, he became very angry. He burnt many monasteries. You see, even in olden days, Kashmir has been destroyed many times. They have been rebuilt many times. That is what we find in even Rajatarangini. He burnt many monasteries and he gave those places to Brahmanas. He built a town on the banks of Vitastha called Kinnarapura. Very rich, very prosperous. Then what happened? Then something totally unexpected happened. This fellow who wrought havoc among Buddhists because a Buddhist kidnapped a queen, he himself engaged in a misdemeanor with a woman, a Naga woman, who was wife of a Brahmana. Then Nagas became their enemies. Nagas are generally on the side of these kings. But this time, Nagas became their enemies because of this. Then Nagas burnt the city, including the king. The king also perished in that fire. And he described the destruction in such terms that the whole area, whole town was full of fat, like Madhukaitabha's fat. Madhukaitabha's fat, which is described in Devi Mahatmyam, came up to the Uru, the thigh of Vishnu. But here, in this case, the fat was so much that it touched Sarvangamasprishat Dagdhanam Praninam Tattatada Sarvangamasprishat. All angas, all limbs of Vishnu were touched by this Medha. Madhukaitabhayor Medha Pragurvoriva Chakrinam, like that he describes. Now, afterwards, that Naga king's sister, even that he described, she destroyed many villages by dropping boulders. Then finally, there was peace established. The one Naga king, he established peace. His name was Sushravas. He constructed a lake on a distant mountain. And that lake is known as Sushravas Lake. That comes in Amarnath Yatra. We mentioned it during our Amarnath Yatra description. It looks like the ocean of milk, he says, which is visited by Yatris going to Amarnath, he says, Kalhana says. Dugdabdi Dabalam Tena Saro Dura Giro Kritam Amareshwara Yatrayam Janehi Adhyapi Drishyate. Even today means during Kalhana's time. Sushravas Lake, it's also called Sheshanag Lake. Sati daivata vipranam apyekasya prakopataha shrutohi prativrittantam trailokyasyapi viplavaha. Now he goes into a moral teaching. He says, ekasya prakopataha, if you incur the wrath of any one of these three, sati daivata viprana, sati, pativrata three, daivata, devas, viprana, brahmanas, Shrutohi prativrittantam trailokyasyapi viplavaha. All the three worlds will come to destruction. Then what to speak of? Only Kashmir. So he says this is what happened because this king incurred the wrath of Nagas and Brahmanas. Now next king was Siddha. This previous king's son, he was just the opposite, very virtuous. He repaired all the evil image which his father had created. He says that. He praises him in so many words. Nashakyate papankena pratime induriva amalaha pratima induriva amalaha. Like his image was unblemished, like the reflection of the moon, even in panka, even in mire, even in slush. Even though there is slush, the image of Chandra does not get affected. Like this, his image was not affected, even though his father had a bad image. Bhogayogena malinyam netum madhyagatopiyaha shashtimabdhan prashasyorbim आसन्न अनुचरान्वितः आरुरोह तदेहोतो लोकान् शशि शिखामणेः. लुक एट द डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ शिवा. शशि शिखामणि, वन हु इज हैविंग मून ऑन हिज हेड. लोकान् शशि शिखामणेः, ही वेंट टू शिवलोक. हाउ? तदेहोतो इन हिज ओन बॉडी, इन हिज ओन बॉडी ही वेंट टू शिवलोक अलोंग विद हिज अटेंडेंट आसन्न अनुचरान्वितः. After 60 years of rule, Shashtim Abdhan Prashasya, that was his greatness. And Devatas sounded their divine drums, Dundubis, for 7 days on his ascending to Shivaloka. Now, that is what Kalhana records. Then there were other kings. Then the king called Mihira Kula. Now, the period is 707 BC. Very violent king, very evil-minded. He killed his own subjects, including children, including women, including elders. Because he wanted money. For getting money from his own citizens, he was merciless in killing them. Then he invaded Lanka for a very silly reason. He invaded Lanka. And on the way, he went through Chola kingdom, Karnataka kingdom. All those kings ran away in fear of him. And such was his viciousness. Once what he did, he was finding that a river called Chandrakulya, a canal, was not flowing properly because of a big stone. And somehow he was told, I don't know who told him, somehow he was told this river course can be corrected only if the stone is displaced at the hands of a chaste woman. So he subjected all the women of Kashmir to the test of chastity by asking them to displace that stone. Look at that. And because they could not displace, they were killed. That was the kind of king. So we have good kings and bad kings. That's what he is describing very nicely. But the same king, after some time, because there are good features as well as bad features in every human being. So he's so human, our Kalhana, he describes so nicely. He says, Mihireshwara temple he founded in the name of his own Mihira, Mihira Kulana, that was his name. Mihireshwara in Srinagar, Mihirapura town he founded. Srinagar yam tu durbuddhihi vidade Mihireshwaram. Durbuddhihi, he says, evil minded fellow, but he founded Mihireshwara. Then, when he faced overrunning by Mlechhas, what did he do? He brought people from Aryan kingdoms, Aryan groups. He settled them and then gave a run to those Mlechhas. He gave agraharams to Brahmanas. But Brahmanas he brought from Gandhara Desha, who were not good, Kalhana records. They were not good Brahmanas. They were a bad character, but he still gave them. And as an act of penance, he entered fire on his own. As an act of penance for all the evils he did, he entered fire on a platform studded with swords. And then he heard Akashwani that all his sins have been pardoned. I mean, that is how Kalhana says. Then there were some more kings. Then we go to Gopaditya, the next king. Now, these stories are long, so I am going to take more time than what Shankar has allotted to me today as well as the next day. Then that is how we can do some justice to Raja Tarangini. Now, next king is Gopaditya. This king's reign was like Satya Yuga, golden age. He expelled Brahmanas who lacked character, according to whom, who ate garlic. Now, Kalhana records this. Kalhana records Brahmanas who ate garlic were expelled from the kingdom. He encouraged good Brahmanas. He established Jyeshtheshwara in Srinagar, in now what is known as Shankaracharya Hill. I mentioned sometime back in respect of another king, Jaloka, but actually now that hill is also known as Gopadri even today. Many people know it as Gopadri. So this must be the king who established Jyeshtheshwara in what is now known as Shankaracharya Hill. In those days it was known as Gopadri. Jyeshtheshwaram pratishthapya Gopadra Gopadrav Aryadeshajaha Gopagrahan Kritina Yena Svikarita Dvijaha Uttamo Lokapaloyam Iti Lakshmi Prashastishuya Praptavan Vinayajyam Chakshamena Sukshayam. He conducted so many yajnas. In fact, lot of kings have conducted lot of yajnas. And this king, when he was conducting yajnas, he said, no animal slaughter. Even only for yajnas, I will allow animal slaughter. Otherwise, no animal slaughter in the entire kingdom. Then his son was Gokarna. Then his son was Narendra Aditya. He founded a temple of Bhuteshwara and a hospital. Bhuteshwara Pratishthanam Akshayanyashchakarakaha Divyanugraha Bhag Ugra Abhisoyasya Gurur Vyadhati. His guru was Ugra, and that guru also established a Shiva in his name, Ugra Abhidaha. Then Yudhishthira the first, the next king. He started very well, but unfortunately he fell a victim to unwise courtiers. He could not distinguish good from the bad. He described beautifully. Sarvatra samadrishtitvam gunoyam khalu yoginaha akirtehe tu samahan doshastu prithivipatehe akirtehe hetuhu. This becomes the reason for akirti, losing your fame, because you are not able to distinguish good from the bad. Sarvatra samadrishtitvam gunoyam khalu yoginaha. For a yogi, it may be a good characteristic not to distinguish good from bad, having samadrishti with every person, but not for a king. Doshastu prithivipatehe. So his own minister, they joined with the enemy, and in a very despicable condition, he took asylum with a neighboring king. Then he goes to the second taranga. The first taranga was very long. The second taranga, second chapter, again it starts with a prayer to, beautiful prayer to Ardhanarishwara. Then he talks about kings Pratapaditya and Jaloka, and the next important king, now we are in BC 105. The king is Tunjina. Dampatibhyamiyam tabhyam abhushtata vasundhara Ganga Mruganga Khanda Bhyam Jatabhuriva Dhurjate. He and his queen were like Ganga and Chandra in the Jata, matted tresses of Shiva. Ganga Mruganga Khanda Bhyam Jatabhuriva Dhurjate. That is how he described he and his queen. So virtuous they were. He established like other king Tungeshwara. And there was one Chandaka in his court, a poet. He was Vyasa's Amsha. Natyam sarvajana prekshyam yashchakresa mahakabihi dvaipayana munerumshaha tatkale chandako bhavat. He wrote a good drama, Chandaka. And at that time, a severe famine struck Kashmir. The famine was so severe, there was complete shortage of food. Then what did the king do? He felt very miserable. He wept. He wished to end his own life. Then what did the queen do? The queen consoled him. Beautifully he describes all this scenery. The queen consoled him. She told him, Patyo bhaktihi vratam strinam adroho mantrinam vratam prajanu palanenanya karmata bhubhritam vratam. For a woman, the vrata is Pati bhakti, patyav bhakti. For a mantri, the vrata is adroha, not committing droha, not conspiring against the king. That is mantri's vrata. Now, for the king, what is the vrata? Prajanupalane ananya karmata bhubhritam vratam. Prajanupalane ananya karmata. Being always engaged, not doing anything else other than praja anupalana, protecting the citizens. So, you cannot run away like this. You cannot wish to end your own life. You have to protect the people somehow. whatever food we have in our palace, whatever food we can arrange with our other king, we shall arrange for them. Then she herself took the lead. She prayed to Shiva, and Shiva blessed the king and the queen. They got some food here and there. They managed. They accommodated in their own palace the poor people who did not have food, who did not have anything. They accommodated. All this is described beautifully by Kalhana. Finally, when the time came for the king to leave his body, the queen also ascended the chita, the funeral pyre of her husband. But he died issueless, without a son. Now, that also Kalhana describes very nicely. He says, he was so virtuous that Bhagavan could not find a son suitable for his virtue. So he could not be given a son. Look at that, how nicely he says. He says, Brahma produced sugar cane to make it forget Amrita. Similarly, he gives an example. Similarly, this king was Amrita, so he could not give him a son. Then there was a king called Vijaya. He founded Vijayeshwara. Then there was a son, a king called Jayendra. Now this Jayendra was very bad. He listened to his evil courtiers. He had a very good minister called Sandhimata, very virtuous minister, Shiva Bhakta. Now this virtuous minister, he impaled him, he killed him. You know, impaling, putting on top of a spike. Very painful killing. Now, this Sandhimata was killed like that. Now, here comes a very interesting story, which is very difficult to believe for people like us. But Kalhana describes in great detail that story. What is the story? When he was impaled, there was another minister who was very favorable to this Sandhimata. He went there, and then he spent the night and day there. This fellow, this king has died already on the top of the spike, and he is just a skeleton now. Now, this skeleton was brought to life by yoginis. Now, yogini devatas are the speciality of Kashmir. You find frequent mention of yoginis in Kashmir. Like you find Shiva, Vishnu, and Sharada, and so many other devatas, you find yoginis. Now, these yoginis, attendants of Devi, they came, and this minister saw them personally with his own eyes. They were able to bring limbs from anywhere, somewhere. They put those limbs to the skeleton. They brought him to life. This man was known as Sandhimati or Sandhiman, and he became known as Arya Raja. He became a great king. Who? This man who was impaled, who died, who was brought back to life by the yogini. He became a great king, a great Shiva Bhakta. He frequented temples of Bhuteshwara, Vardhamaneshwara, Vijayeshwara. He spent a lot of time only with Shiva Bhakta. He was like a rishi, he said. Tapasair bhasma rudraksha jata jota ankitair babhav tasya maheshwari parshta jiva bhumi pate sabha. His sabha, his court, was like Shiva's sabha in Kailasa, Maheshwari Parshati Iva. Every day he used to make 1,000 Shivalingas, and after puja he used to immerse them. So those streams where he used to immerse them look like Narmada. And Akarostha Mahaharmyaihi Mahalingaihi Mahamrushaihi Mahatrishulaihi Mahati Mahamaheshwaro Mahim. Everything Maha, all great, great temples, great Rishabhas. Mahamrishaihi, Mahalingaihi, Mahaharmyaihi, great temples, Mahatrishulaihi. Like this, he constructed a lot of Shiva temples and granted a lot of property for maintaining those temples. He also constructed Sandhishwara, Ishaneshwara, that kind of Shiva temples. Svayambhuvishya tirtheshya putam bhakti visheshataha sayeva bhoktam ajnati prajnaha Kashmira mandalam was full of bhakti in his time. Full of tirthas, full of sacred bhumi. He took great pleasure in Shiva Abhisheka, Pushparadhana, etc. He used to lose himself in Shiva Dhyana for a long time. Many nights he used to spend in forest along with rishis. He was looking like a rishi himself. So in due course, his royal duties took a back seat. He had to resign his kingship. He retired to the woods as a vanaprastha. Now starts the third taranga, again with a beautiful prayer to Ardhanarishwara. It starts with a king named Meghavahana. This is BC 24. He restored Gonanda dynasty, because we found some kings from other dynasties had come in between. He restored Gonanda dynasty. Very kind-hearted, very virtuous king. He forbade animal slaughter completely, including yajnas. He constructed Agrahara called Meghavana. This kind of description you find with almost all kings. His queen, Amrita Prabha, she built Vihara for Buddhists, Amrita Bhavan. Then once what happened, this king, a certain situation came when a boy had to be saved from Chandika's krodha. So if you want to save the body from Chandika, then you have to give your own body. That kind of situation came. And this king offered his own body as a sacrifice to Chandika. At that time, Varuna appeared in person and praised him and prevented this sacrifice. This is similar to the story of Dilipa and the lion, Nandini and the lion in Raghuvamsham. We are all familiar with that story. Similar story we find here with this. He not only stopped animal slaughter in his own kingdom, he stopped animal slaughter even in the Rakshasa kingdom of Lanka. He went to Lanka personally. At that time, there was a king called Vibhishana in Lanka. He stopped animal slaughter there and he won over those people there by mere love. So they liked him so much, they gave this king flags of Lanka, and those flags were carried in Kashmir in royal ceremonial processions. Like this, he records beautiful details. Then on another occasion, a Brahmana complained that Durga Devi demanded animal slaughter from him. Otherwise, his son would die. Then the king said, no, I will offer my own body. And he offered his own body to Durga. Then during the night, Durga came in person, appeared in person and prevented his sacrifice. So like this, we find two stories in his case. Beautiful. Then came another king called Pravarasena. He established Matri Chakra. We saw Matri Chakra before. He also established Matri Chakra. Then he was followed by a king called Hiranya. Then what happened? This previous king, Pravarasena had died. Then this Hiranya came. Hiranya also died. Then Hiranya's brother's son, he was named as also Pravarasena. He went abroad. He was a child at that time. Then Hiranya having died, there was no king in Kashmir. The situation came and there was no king in Kashmir. The child king had gone out abroad to save his own life. And at that time, Vikramaditya was the king in Ujjain. The matters were intimated to Vikramaditya. Then what did Vikramaditya do? He sent a poet called Matri Gupta. He, all of us know, he encouraged a lot of poets, a lot of scholars. This Matri Gupta was tested for a long time by Vikramaditya. He found he was extremely virtuous. He was suitable for being, he was a Brahmana, no doubt. He was not a Kshatriya, but still he chose him to become king of Kashmir. He sent him to Kashmir, not as a king, very interesting. Even that story is told by Kalhana in great detail. He sent him as a messenger with a message. The message was saying that the bearer of this message will be your king. But he didn't know. This man did not know that he was carrying such a message. He went and gave it to the ministers there. The ministers, on opening the message, they were surprised. They said, are you Matri Gupta? He said, I am Matri Gupta. So what? I am the messenger. He said, no, no, you are not messenger. You are the king. That is how he became king. He conducted a lot of yajnas, very virtuous. He forbade animal slaughter again. There was a poet called Mentha in his kingdom who composed Hayagriva Vadham. He put up a temple for Matri Gupta Swami, Madhusudana, Vishnu. Whenever Swami comes, it is generally Vishnu. Whenever Ishvara comes, it is Shiva. That's how Kalhana describes these various temples. Then in the meantime, this Matrugupta was, Varki was king for quite some time. Then in the meantime, the child king, Prabhasena, who was abroad, he came back. He wanted to take over the kingdom. And he wanted to fight with Vikramaditya, because Vikramaditya had sent his own man as a king here. But by the time he went to Vikramaditya for fighting, Vikramaditya had died. When Matrugupta came to know that Vikramaditya had died, and as we have seen, he was a very virtuous man, he didn't want to continue being the king. He abandoned the kingdom. He went to Kashi. Now, this Prabhasena went to Matrugupta. He said, no, you cannot abandon the kingdom. Don't think that I want to take over from you. You can continue to be the king here. He offered the kingdom to him. But Matrugupta refused. He said, I want to go to Kashi, worship Vishveshwara there. I want to spend my last days in Kashi. Then finally, he was allowed to go to Kashi by Prabhasena. But he, whatever personal property this Matrugupta had in Kashmir, and whatever returns were there from those properties, he sent them to Kashi, to Matrugupta. Even that is being recorded by Kalhana. Such was now the closeness that prevailed between Vikramaditya, Matrugupta, and this Prabhasena. He describes beautifully. He says, this kind of anyonya bhava you will not find anywhere. Anyonyam sabhimananam anyonya auchityashalinam auchityashalinam prayana apipavrittanta yesha tripathaga pathaha. This is like tripathaga, like Ganga, who had three paths, one in Swarga, another in Earth, another in Patala. Like these three people, beautiful. Then the Prabhasena, who became king, he was a great king. He was a great king in various respects. He had a military conquest. Like Agastya, he followed the seas and traversed the mountains. He is compared with Agastya. He brought back the Kashmir throne from the city of Vikramaditya. When he was building a city and he was setting up Prabhareshwara Shiva, he was directed to go to the village where Devi Sharika and Yaksha Atta were there. The first time we find Sharika Devi being mentioned, as we know, Sharika Devi, the great Devi in Kashmir. Even today, we know Sharika Parvata, known as Hara Parvata nowadays. It was known as Sharitaka, that village. He was directed to go there. He had darshan of Sharika Devi. Then, during the consecration of this Prabhareshwara, the Swayambhu, there was a Swayambhu Shiva which came up from the earth. He was called Jayaswami. He took his seat in the basement on his own. He came up and he sat there. All these miracles are described here. Then another image of Vinayaka, Bhima Swami. Now he was facing the west initially. He turned on his own and he faced the east. Like this, some miracles are described. He constructed bridge across Vitastha. Now, a lot of kings have constructed bridges across Vitastha to connect the southern and the northern banks. And on the left bank of Vitastha, he established Pravarapura with 36 lakhs of houses. And he was like second Surya, he says. Vishade ghatayan vyomni dvitiya tapanodayam. And when he went, when he dropped his body, he went to Kailasa and people were able to see him going to Kailasa. Janaisa dadushe gachanne Kailasa tilakam disham evam sa bhuvaneshwaryam bhukta bhumi bhritam varaha anenaiva sharirene bheje bhutapate sabha bhutapate he sabha. I mentioned earlier, Shiva is referred by several names. Here he is referred by name of Bhutapati. He went to Shivaloka anenaiva sharirene with his own sharira. Then King Yudhishthira II, then King Narendra Aditya, he founded Narendra Swami. He was the first king. He founded an office for preservation of written records, this Narendra Aditya. Then Rana Aditya, he was also called Zunjina, another great king. He used to hold his court even in the night, and even in the night it used to shine like a day. That was the glory. And very interesting story is told by Kalhana about this Ranaditya. His queen was named Ranarambha. And in previous birth, she was Devi herself, Bhramaravasini Devi. This king was a dice player, ordinary player. He went to Vindhyas to have Bhramaravasini Darshan. At that time, he had Darshan of Bhramarambika. Then after finishing the temple Darshan, he came out and he saw a beautiful girl. He thought that she was an Apsara. She was so beautiful, he wanted to marry. But that Apsara turned out to be Devi herself. Devi herself was giving him Darshan in her own form. But she had given a word that she will give him whatever boon he wanted. He wanted a boon to marry her. Now what can she do? Since she said, I cannot marry you, I am Devi. So I will marry you in next birth. So the Brahmareshwari Devi has come as Rambha, as Ranarambha in this birth. And she was the queen now. And because she was Devi herself, she never allowed him to touch her. Even during the night, she used to leave another woman on his bed and she used to go out. And he built Raneshwara and Ranaswami temples. And the images prepared by him were defective and they were replaced by the queen because she was Devi herself with her own Siddhi. She brought beautiful images and she said these images were used by Shiva during his marriage with Parvati. Then he built hospital for the sick. He built a Buddhist monastery. This queen taught Shiva Hatakeshwara mantra. No wonder, because she was Devi herself. And he could go down to Patala. He built a matha of Pashupatas on the top of Pradyumna Hill. Now this Pradyumna Hill is the Hari Parvat where Sharika Devi we saw last time. He founded a matha of Pashupatas. Very divine rule. And he says, like Rama was in that Raghu's lineage, in Gonanda lineage, Ranaditya should be compared to Rama. Ranadityasya Gonanda Vamshe Ramasya Raghave Lokantara Sukhasya Piyo Ramsha Bhuja Prajaha. Then there was a king called Vikramaditya, then he was followed by Baladitya. Now we have come to AD 559. Baladitya's period is AD 559. Now, his military glory is described so beautifully by Kalhana. He says, the mouths of the women of the enemies, the mouths of the women of the enemy, they used to suffer excessive thirst. They are drinking of the salt sea of their tears. They were shedding so much of tears. By drinking their saltish tears, they used to develop thirst. लवणार्णवपानेन तर्षोत्कर्षमिवोद्वहन् यत् प्रतापो रिपुस्त्रीणां सनेत्रां भोजजन्मुखम्. He also constructed Agrahara in Madava Rajya and he was the last king in the Gonanda dynasty. We stop here. Then we have Karkotaka Naga dynasty which comes in the next Taranga, which we will take up in our next lecture next Saturday. All of you, please join next Saturday at 7 p.m. IST. Today we have taken a little more time. We hope to take a little more time next time also because the story is very long. Shankar should bear with me. Kanchi Kamakoti Peetham also should bear with me. Nama Parvati Pataye Hara Hara Mahadeva Sarvatra Govinda Nama Sankirtanam Govinda Govinda श्री जगदंबिकायै जय जया सद्गुरु स्वामिनः जय.
थैंक यू श्री कानन जी. इट वाज रियली ग्रेट नैरेटिव एंड यू एक्चुअली मेंशन 2 आवर्स बट यू रिड्यूस्ड बाय 30 मिनट्स एंड कट शॉर्ट टू 1.5 आवर्स. वी विल हैव राज तरंगिणी कंटिन्यूएशन. Kashmir Mandalam and everything is Maha, like you mentioned. You also talked about Sharda Peetham. I just want to remind all our viewers that we are going to be covering Sharda Peetham also, which is actually we're going to a place close to Baramulla and the POK border. Kashmir is full of temples, like some of you asked about it, most of them in ruins. And it's great. We will have more coverage on the temples. You also mentioned about moral statements, which are quite valid today. You talked about turning of the tide and about the luck. I think those are the few interesting aspects. This is our fourth in series, and it's second for Kananji. And we will have four more sessions. Please join us next Saturday. And you have to subscribe to the channel so that you'll get all the intimation. Thank you once again for the time. And I could see that viewership didn't go down, even though you extended beyond 1 hour. So everyone is fixated, stay tuned. So we will meet next week again. We thank Raja, VDSP, and also thank Kanjimat team for accommodating us in Kamakodi TV, YouTube, and Facebook Kamakodi Kanjimat channels. Thank you very much. We'll close now.